Yes.
You heard the news.
The news?
Mm-hmm.
I have about 200 pages of briefings from the Office of Special Affairs, so which news? Which flapping flap?
HBO mm-hmm. and Louis Theroux of the BBC are racing to do tell-all documentaries on the Church of Scientology.
I heard the news. HBO and Louis Theroux are, in fact, Alex Gibney said that he's going to get 160 lawyers.
Not he's going to get. There are 160 lawyers already viewing the documentary.
Now, I have a hard time with this 160 lawyers thing because as I calculate in America, the Church of Scientology has over 200 lawyers
mm-hmm.
oh, working on me. Existing cases. Mm-hmm. We need to hire more lawyers to help create the 160 HBO lawyers.
We need to use dirty tricks.
Dirty tricks.
Yes. It is mm-hmm. command intention. Do it. Is Alex Gibney being followed? Is Alex Gibney being harassed?
You're talking about private investigators.
Yes.
Look, what you need is deniability.
Mm-hmm.
You, as the seer, don't need to know what I, as your WAG attorney, am doing. You need deniability. But hypothetically speaking, if we were to follow Mr. Gibney or dig through his trash by phone records,
mm-hmm.
We're acting in ways that Mr. Miscavige approves of, I would think,
mm-hmm.
were he actually in command.
I'm going to give you an unlimited budget here.
Oh, an unlimited budget.
I want Very you to good. Stop this. I want, you know, those threat letters, I want the threat letters off the charts.
Oh, we're going to make serious threat letters to mm-hmm. Louis Theroux,
mm-hmm.
HBO, Alex Gibney,
mm-hmm.
and their attorneys and producers and all kinds of things.
Mm-hmm.
You know what? We did stop South Park in England.
Mm-hmm.
So we should be able to stop these things in some countries.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe not the United States, but we'll put the fear of God in them.
I don't think we have that much time. I think that it goes to the film festival Sundance in January.
Oh, we can always file for emergency motions and these kind of things, ask the court for emergency injunctions, stuff like that. There's lawyer things we can do.
Look, for years, the media were scared of the Church of Scientology.
Indeed.
They were backed off. They had absolute visceral reaction.
Terrifying.
To taking on the church. We need to get back to those glory days. Let's take the brakes off.
Okay.
I want Louis Theroux and his entire team. I want mm-hmm. them spied on.
Spied on.
Get their phone records in the last 360,
okay.
the last 12 months.
Right.
Legally or illegally, mm-hmm. get their phone records. I want to know which apostates they've been talking to and filming.
We want to find out what former church members they've been talking to.
Yes.
If they have any communist affiliations.
Mm-hmm.
Or anything salacious we should know about. Now, one question though. Now, I'm your attorney. This thing at LAX, where some of your Sea Org colleagues harassed a former member of the church, that caught us off guard. Are there going to be any surprises with the BBC or HBO that I should know about?
You may need deniability because you give. You're acting as spokesman. I don't want you to know of anything that might surprise you.
No, but I mean, are there going to be any kind of loopy Sea Org members showing up telling people that...
No comment. Listen,
yes.
listen. This rolls back to Larry Wright. This whole HBO thing rolls back to Larry Wright.
Yes, I know Larry Wright. I asked you... to not give Larry Wright, what was it, 60 bankers' boxes of materials? You thought it would be a good idea to bury him in materials. And his publisher said, you got a book here, Larry. So I would suggest with HBO, especially Alex Gibney, don't give him 60 banker's boxes of anything.
Are you trying to say that David Miscavige's genius idea of sending 60 banker boxes of church material to Larry Wright gave him the book?
Yes.
That is now causing the HBO fallout?
We had, eventually we had 7 fact checkers on that story. And you know, one attorney, I was a little worried about that because when the Scientologists came to our magazine to confront us, you know, about what we were about to write, they brought 4 lawyers, and they have lots of lawyers, but
4 lawyers and 47 white binders, as I recall.
That's right. We had sent 971 fact-checking queries. That was the first volley, and it was like dead quiet for a while, and then suddenly, you know, I had been trying to get them to talk to me, and they wouldn't talk to me. So suddenly, this delegation, the church's chief spokesperson, Tommy Davis, and his wife and assistant, and these 4 lawyers came with these legal binders, and they stretched out 7 linear feet, and these were supposed to be responses to our 971 queries. And I don't know if they thought they were going to drown me in information, but you can't drown a reporter in information. It's like pouring water on a fish. You know, it's like I couldn't believe it. I was so full of joy. And when the meeting was finally over, I got a dolly and I took all those binders down to this disused computer room in the Yorker offices, and I lined them all up on the desk, and I just looked at them, you know, just with such pleasure, because I knew that inside there, you know, just as during this epic meeting, it's kind of legendary now at the New Yorker, during a bathroom break, David Remnick pulled me aside and said, "Well, you know what you got here, you schmuck? You got a book." Yeah. Yeah, David, I know.
Basically, he used a lot of material from the boxes. I'm saying the less you give your critics, the better. The less. Your policy of not having a spokesman is working. You have to admit it. Not having a spokesman, not saying anything like we've been counseling you, has been working, right? No. Since Tommy Davis left, you haven't had one single spokesman who's been laughed at. You haven't had a spokesman, period, and that's, I think, an effective PR strategy for the church. So I would say we'll send threat letters, and on the top of them, we're going to write in a red pen, "not for publication," to their lawyers. And if we do things right, I think that these journalists will be terrified of the church's Scientology once again.
Good. Let them shake and shiver.
We'll do that. We'll make them shake and shiver. Hey, by the way, how about you and I go out for a drink?
Mr. Mills, we have a planet to clear. We're helping mankind, and you want to go and have a drink?
So is that a no or a yes?
Are you flirting with me?
I'm not on the clock, if that's what you're saying.